Please rise. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Daniel died with Christ, and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. In baptism, Daniel received the sign of the cross. May he now share in Christ's victory over sin and death.
Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Finally, brothers, rejoice. Mend your ways, encourage one another, agree with one another, live in peace, and the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the holy ones greet you. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please rise. Saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you, and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. It was just over 3 weeks ago we gathered here to pray for Linda. And at that time, praying too that Daniel might recover. It seemed like maybe he would, but unfortunately that's not how things worked out. So in the span of a few short weeks, I understand you've lost your parents, your grandparents, or your friends, your family, and it's a very difficult time for you, and I'm very sorry that you have to go through these days. It seems like things as they were, in a way, have come to an end, which is why it occurred to me that today is a fitting day for this celebration. Because in the Catholic Church, today is called, technical term, Saturday of the 34th week of Ordinary Time. Tomorrow is called the first Sunday of Advent. That means that today is the end of the church's year, and that tomorrow is the start of something new, a new year. And at Mass during these last few days, the daily Mass, we've been hearing a lot of readings from the book of Revelation. And the readings have been very serious. They've been talking a lot about the end, not just the end of the year, but at the end of the world, of judgment, of hell and heaven. So these days remind us that there will be an end to our life, to our world, and that we should be prepared to meet Jesus at any moment as our judge. But lest that seem a little bit too somber, think of tomorrow. Said, tomorrow begins the season of Advent. It's a new year, new beginning. And the year begins with a season of waiting, of building anticipation, of hope. One little symbol of that waiting is the Advent wreath. Ours is a little bit related, it's over there, but it's not lit yet, right? One candle each week counting down the days, our hope, our anticipation building as the arrival of Jesus at Christmas draws closer. So while today is a really somber day in the church and in your life and in your family, we're also on the verge of a season of hope. That's why it's fitting, too, I think, that you've chosen a reading from the start of the Sermon on the Mount for Daniel's funeral. Jesus listed off the Beatitudes, different paths to happiness. This is God's plan for happiness. And, his Beatitudes, these paths, they're not what we expect, right? We tend to think that to be happy, we need to avoid all suffering. Although I think what you told me last night, I don't think Daniel thought that necessarily. He endured a lot of things, but yet he was still a great dad, right? He was still there for you. He had a lot of suffering. But in the world, we tend to think that to be happy, we've got to get rid of all that hardship and suffering. And we need to be healthy, we need to be strong. But one thing that becomes very clear when we attend funerals is that we can't be perfectly happy in this life, right? There are great moments, even great years, right? But there's always something missing, some perfect happiness. But there is a desire in each of us for perfect happiness. God made us with that desire. He put it in us that we would never be totally satisfied in this life. And that, some argue that God would not allow such a desire. He would not put such a desire within us if it was incapable of being fulfilled. And so we believe it can be fulfilled, just not here and now. In this life. That's why the Beatitudes say things like, blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. And blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. In this life, even on our best days, right, we're approaching the end. But we hope for more. We hope to see God as He is, face to face in the next life, side by side with all the saints. See, that's where our real life begins. So we hope for Daniel, for Linda, for other family members, for ourselves, not just for a healthy and happy life here and now, or not just for an end of suffering and illness once old age starts to take its toll, but we hope for eternal joy. We might suffer a bit in this life, or quite a bit, as I know Daniel did, but it's nothing compared with the glory of heaven. All the suffering, no matter how terrible it seems in this life, is nothing compared to the glory of heaven. So as this holiday season rolls by this year, I'm sure things are going to be very different in your family. It's going to be, I imagine, rather difficult. There's probably going to be some tears. But remember this, we are entering a season of hope. Because of the newborn baby Jesus on Christmas Day, Daniel, and all of us, we still have hope. We're all meant for more than this life. We're made for heaven. And as a little aside, it seems God in his providence has arranged things really at the end quite well for Daniel. He was well prepared to meet Jesus, I think. He received the graces of Jesus and the anointing of the sick in his last days. He got to be with some of you, some of his family in his last days. Some of you got to say goodbye and so on. As difficult as it was, it is, in a way, it was also beautiful. It seems like God worked it out in his providence, and we thank him for that. So let us now continue this Mass, pray for his soul, helping him on his journey to the real life we were made for, real happiness. And let us remember that we too ought to live every day now in such a way as to someday join the saints in heaven. Amen. Please rise. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
In baptism, Daniel received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our brother Daniel was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly food banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Daniel seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come with grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Daniel. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
You shall wander far and sweetly, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your
my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Please rise. As we humbly present to you, O Lord, these sacrificial offerings for the salvation of your servant Daniel, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection is dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. So that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and David our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember your servant Daniel, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Just a brief word about the reception of Holy Communion. Catholics that are in a state of grace are welcome to come forward and receive Holy Communion. Other Catholics or people who are not Catholic, may either remain in their seat, or if you do come forward, just put your hands over your chest like this to indicate to me that you would just like a prayer. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant us, strengthened by it, our brother may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
You can join on number 830, Song of Farewell.
Say Thank you.